and welcome to Little Known Copenhagen, where we show you hidden gems in some of the world's best known locations. I'm Alexis Sita, thanks for joining us. Well, here in Copenhagen, more people are on bicycles than there are in cars. So if you want to experience the city like the Danes do, consider hopping a bike and joining the cycle culture. People aren't in a race and they're not out for a leisurely ride. They're part of the thousands getting to work by bike.
And Copenhageners choose the bicycle because it's the quickest way to get around. In Greater Copenhagen, the metropolitan area, there's about 500,000 people on bicycles every single day. I always try to point out that these people are not cyclists, as you would probably, you know, that image that you have of cyclists in North America. Nor are they environmentalists. When you ask the people of Copenhagen, and we do this every 2 years, what their main reason for choosing the bike is, they say, 56% say, oh, it's easy and fast. It's simply the quickest way for me to get around the city. Only 1% say they do it for environmental reasons. So if you make the bicycle the fastest way to get through a city, the most convenient, and even in a snowstorm and the rain, people will ride.
This isn't a novelty for residents of Denmark's capital city. These cyclists pedaled their way through Copenhagen every day, since most of them have decided not to own cars.
I've never owned a car. I've always owned bicycles. I live in Copenhagen now. I've lived here for 10 years, and I'm not even considering buying a car. I'm happy with my bike. Get me from A to B without any hassle, snow, rain, sunshine. I don't really care.
Copenhagen has a long, proud tradition of using the bicycle from the day the safety bicycle, the design that we know today, was born. Danes have really embraced it. I always try to point out, though, that basically every country and every city in the world has the same tradition. In Los Angeles, in the year 1900, the modal share for bikes was 20%. 20% of the population rode bikes in LA. We know what happened after that with the boom of car culture. And the same thing happened here in Copenhagen. We started revolving our urban planning around cars in the late 1950s, and the number of cyclists just started to plummet. And it took the oil crisis in the 1970s and a real grassroots movement among regular citizens to start saying, hey, you know, it's dangerous now to ride bikes. We want separated infrastructure. Background here is called Nørrebrogade, Northbridge Street, and it's the busiest bicycle street in the Western world. There's about 35 to 38,000 people on bicycles every day on this street, heading to the city in the morning, coming back at night. On this street, they're all funneled towards the city center, so it's quite a special place. And there's also a lot of urban planning projects that have been put to work here. They've doubled the bike lanes. They made them double wide here because of the traffic. They've restricted car traffic on the street, so cars in the morning rush hour, they can't drive all the way into the city. They have to turn off. It makes it more difficult for them. And the other great thing that we started here in Copenhagen on this street is called the Green Wave. So for about 6 kilometers out of the city center or towards the city center, there's a green wave for cyclists. So if you ride your bike 20 kilometers an hour, you'll hit green lights all the way into the city center. You won't put a foot down. The city of Copenhagen in this modern era has embraced the bicycle. Our urban planning revolves around the bicycle now. You think bicycle first and cars second.
And the city isn't putting the brakes on their cycling conveniences. This busy bridge may just offer a glimpse into the future. Its constant flow of traffic doesn't include any cars. It's easy to lose count of the miles you cover when riding through Copenhagen. The roads are flat, their love of design and architecture is evident on every street, and there are plenty of places to park. The Danes can spend thousands of dollars on bikes that are tricked out with different colors and carriages. And in a country with a population of just 5.5 million, they buy about 600,000 bikes each year. But tourists can benefit from this high turnover. Many of these bikes end up at rental shops, which are found in every neighborhood. At this shop in the center of Copenhagen, they believe not only in the efficiency of riding, but the great experience it offers.
I want people to know that bike riding is an affordable, easy way of transportation without the hassles of cars and what they can bring by just not just pollution, but also people sit in a car, you know, they are in a box, they're in their own little world, and when you're on a bike, you're taking more part in it. You can look people in the eyes, you can smell, listen, you really feel like you're part of the city. And basically, when you're biking on your bike in Copenhagen, there's a few rules that you gotta follow to make your ride enjoyable. And basic rules is that if you wanna brake your bike and you wanna hold your bike, you raise your arm to indicate to the people behind you that you will be braking and stopping, and people won't come crashing into you. Instead, they'll just drive around you. And always, when you're driving in Copenhagen, it's important then to keep orientated. So before doing anything, braking or making a right turn, you always have a glimpse over your shoulder to see if there's anybody coming, racing down the road, and always stick to the right.
Well, that's going to do it for us here on Little Known Copenhagen, where we show you hidden gems and some of the world's best known locations. I'm Alexa Sita. Thanks for joining us. And remember, keep to the right. I have to get behind you. This woman is trying to get behind you. It's tricky, though, because sometimes the lights are just... there's no separate life for the bike, and sometimes there is.
No.
Pedestrians. All right, you have to yield to pedestrians, which is not easy to do when you're on a bike. And the light for the pedestrian isn't the light for the bike, although he's going. Yeah, what do you do when a truck is double parked? No hand signal and he cut you off. Hand signal.